Last time, I'm just kidding. I don't do that shit. Okay, dude, boys, how did, fellas.
How did
you're all?
How did Zelos get a picture of me to put on there?
I don't know. He found it's probably was easy to find because we uploaded all those pictures on the internet from that one time. Remember when you did the? Yeah. You know when you did that thing.
The real question is, how did Zell get a picture of me to make for his character sheet?
I don't even think
that's the same picture of Bear Grylls that I used that he did. It's not. Is it?
No, I just grabbed a random one off Google. You know, with that picture specifically, I kind of see it in the in the face.
Yeah.
It's weird, dude.
It's very bizarre.
Okay, well, let's have an adventure. Dude, deal with it. It's Bear Grylls. There's a million pictures of him everywhere.
Okay, you're right.
Set the scene.
Okay, listen. You guys are all sitting together, you know, in a war camp, in a siege camp, dude, around a around a large castle with big ass walls. You guys are just sitting by the fire, and, it's a crack of dawn, you know, the sun's just coming up, and you're having breakfast with your good old Sergeant Sizzle. Alright, lads, it's been a couple months, it's gonna be any day now we're going over that wall. Hope you lot are ready, because, you know, it's gonna be bloody up there. You're gonna have to fight for your lives.
Now, you see, sir, why do we have to go over the wall? You see, I could just rig up some dynamite to that and just blow a nice big hole just for us to walk right through it.
Yeah, well, I don't know. I guess the guys up top, they want to keep the wall intact. So, you know, otherwise we'd have more siege equipment out here. Don't blow the wall up is what I'm saying. Okay?
Walls were made to be smashed.
Soldier.
See, I think that they're going to expect that we're behind the wall.
Oh, who the fuck are you? What?
Pardon? I told you not to speak, man. Ugh.
Sergeant, we have someone who's infiltrated our camp.
Did you brush your teeth today? Jesus Christ.
The fuck is a tooth?
Oh, God, dude. What are you even eating, man? Is that a cat? Ugh. Where did you find that thing?
I draw my sword at Nasty Nerd. Leave our camp immediately.
Which is soldier?
I hide immediately.
Put that sword away. That's private inert. Okay, you can't just be attacking our soldiers. You know, we need him. He could scare off the entire enemy force.
I collect the explosives I was placing under his chair.
And as you guys are just chowing down, and Sergeant Sizzle, he's looking your equipment over, making sure you guys are all full and ready. And you hear the sound of trumpets.
Now approaching the High Culinary Commander and Chef, Captain Crouton.
And you know. a full, you know, large regiment of highly decorated, you know, like, armored knights. They're sort of walking past you on their horses, riding past you. And you see it there, you know, in the middle of them, there's this fellow sitting on a mighty steed, you know, with, emblazoned with, you know, golden pots and pans and whatnot. And he's clanging as he approaches you. He says, Sergeant Chisel!
Yes, Captain Crouton. What? How may I serve you?
Yes, your men. You and these chaps will take the western gate and hold it until we have taken the eastern wall and then the castle itself with the primary force. Do you understand?
Yes, sir.
He salutes, your sergeant says, gives a salute.
Yes, sir. We'll get right on it. We'll put the ladders up immediately. Good on you.
And Captain Crouton, he rides away with his procession, back towards the front line on the eastern wall.
Well, you heard him, boys. Come on, get the ladders. It's time to do this. Are you fellas ready?
Sire, yes, sire.
Oh, of course, sir. Absolutely, I'm ready. Just show me what I need to blow up.
Well, not yet. Perhaps that'll come to happen. Not yet. No blowing up. We're over the walls, boys. Over the walls.
And he rushes to the pile of makeshift ladders you have, and you've constructed over the past few weeks. And he tells you each to, grab a ladder. And you hear the horns of battle blow. It's time to start the siege. And you hear thousands of chefs. Oh, chefs? Shit. Oh, I forgot to do the backstory.
Chefs?
Oh, shit. Oh, yeah, you guys know that you're mercenaries hired by the chef's guard to assault the baker's bash in this castle in front of you.
Oh, of course. No, that makes sense.
I guess that
we were briefed on that.
Yeah, this seems Anyway, so yeah, the high chef, which they spell with a K because he's the king chef, he wants, there's something he wants from the castle. It's high chef, chef with a K. K-H-E-F.
Okay. Thanks.
Yeah, he's demanding, the king chef, he demands that we take this castle for the glory of the chef's guard. Doesn't. No, the bakers are who we're fighting against.
The baker's dozen are a highly trained group of elite assassins.
Alright. Okay, so Sergeant Sizzle, once you've all... I'm guessing you guys are getting the ladders and stuff, right?
Yeah.
I'm actually going to increase my survivability, and I'm going to dig under the wall.
Yeah, what's the flip to rocket jump over the wall?
I'm glad we all had something planned for this, apparently.
Okay, give me a second. I'm going to say some stuff, and then we can do some flips for this stuff.
Can I equip the sticky jumper and go over the wall like that?
No. As definitely no sticky jumper. As he was, as Sergeant Sizzle picks up his own ladder, he says, "All right, boys, the Western Wall. It should be lightly guarded if the main force is attacking on the east. So we're gonna get up there, and they're gonna want us to hold that Western Gate. I don't think they want anybody leaving this castle today.
I'm gonna make sure everyone survives.
So we're gonna make
sure
we hold this gate when we get in there. We're not gonna let anybody out, all right, boys?" And then you start digging under the wall. Okay, give me
I'm digging under to make sure as many people survive and escape this castle.
You know what? I'm gonna sneak through the front gate.
You're gonna sneak through the front gate.
Yeah. It's the last place they'd expect.
Okay. Fuck, okay. Let's see. So, okay, let's go through by order of who asked first, okay? What's the first thing? Somebody's digging a hole under the wall. You still want to do that?
Yeah.
Okay. Digging a hole.
Yeah.
Okay, Barry.
Then Dingle is maybe rocket jumping.
He's a survivor, okay. So give me... I don't know. Is digging survival or engineering?
I can blow a hole up. I've got explosives, too.
I would call it survival.
Okay, yeah, I feel like digging I feel like this is sort of like digging a trench, which I'd say survival.
Give me bronze survival to dig a hole under the wall. Okay. I'm assuming the wall, the western wall, which you're meant to
be. Yeah, whichever wall we gotta go over or under, or whatever wall.
Dingle, give me a... wit explosives to hop over the wall with your explosives.
Alright.
And,
I've got three.
Mr. Snurtly, give me a, so how do you want to, sneak through the front gate? Like, just be like, how the fuck are you going to sneak through the front gate? It's closed.
Maybe it's cracked open a jar and they think it's closed.
Yeah, like I crack it open a jar while no one's looking and slip through, you know?
Okay, I gotta give you a crazy roll for this one, then.
I like the idea that, like, people so don't want to make eye contact with him that he just sort of, like, walks past them and they're like, ugh, what's he doing? I don't know!
give me... Presence and persuasion, maybe? Or sneaking? Presence or persuasion or sneaking, sure.
I'll definitely give you sneaking.
Yeah, give me sneaking, yeah. Presence, sneaking.
Damn.
Off to a roaring start.
Okay. Do this in
deserved.
So, Doc, first off, Mr. Bear Grylls, can I do a Bear Grylls voice?
Yeah.
Can you?
This is the way we're gonna survive after a siege of the night.
That's pretty good!
I begin by digging a hole under the western wall that we'll need to be taking tonight. And you know, you just start digging like a perfect fucking tunnel, like right under the wall, dude. You know,
yo, what the fuck? That's a great Bear Grylls impression.
you're putting up the the wooden beams and shit.
And yeah, it's a proper entrance. Though.
Yeah, you've even disguised both the holes, so it's like wild predators wouldn't really be able to tell that you're sleeping under there. You know, you've disguised your scent. You found a way to store piss in there just in case you need a sip later. It's a nice little tunnel you dug out. Dingle, you sit on like a cart full of hay, you know, and you put some TNT behind it, you know, and you're like, I got this.
My wife was telling me about this guy. If he needed to get anywhere, he just fired a rocket at his feet. He flew in the right direction. I just think that's such a concept, sir.
as the fuse is burning down, boom! And you're launched towards the wall, and you don't quite get over it, but you're now hanging on the edge of it. Like on the battlement, whatever. You know what I mean? You're hanging on the edge of the fucking wall.
All right.
We're trying to get 30 the
feet
castle,
up in there.
Right?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, okay.
Yeah, you're on the other side of the wall. He's on top of the wall, almost.
He's on the precipice of the
outside of the wall. I imagine it won't be too hard for me to sort of clamber up it.
No, it wouldn't be, yeah. And there doesn't seem to be anybody, on the wall above you at this time. And, Nasty Nerd. I'm trying to... I think...
Do you want me to flip mine before you do his Joker?
No, I mean, you could, but it probably won't affect it.
Okay.
Nasty nerd, you are, you sort of slip away from the party because, you know, they don't seem to be really messing with you today, and you think, oh, what's up, Grandpa? Sorry, 1 second. I left my laundry in the freaking...
Oh shit, I have laundry too.
Yeah, I will do it later. Dude.
I need to put it in the dryer in a little bit, I guess.
Okay, but you, what happens to you, nasty nerd, is, as you're making your way to the Eastern Gate, you know, you make it there in pretty decent time. You sort of do your little sprint hobble thing, you know.
Yeah.
It looks disgusting. But you make it to the front gate and you know, it's pretty hectic, you know, there's hundreds and hundreds of people, and you get all the way up past, you know, the front lines straight to the gate, and it looks like they're already ramming it, and it's sort of rhythmic. Bang! 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 You think, oh, I could slip through one of these. And, you try to squeeze through the gate, but, bang! You're sort of knocked through it, actually. And then you take 3 damage, but as you're thrown into the base, you know, you're sort of sliding along the ground, and something gets stuck on your head. You can't get it off. And, it feels like somebody grabs the back of your shirt. Stand up! We need to go now, soldier! And, you're whisked away by some strange knight. And,
oh, wow, a real good night.
Well, I mean, he's dressed in armor. Give me, actually, if you want, you can give me, where's your character? What would it be? Okay, give me... intelligence space wise. To see if you know who this guy is.
I'm definitely not worth... healthy anymore. Actually.
Also, did you pull those out of Bear Grylls' deck?
I did. That's where my deck normally is. I'll put these back in shuffle.
Hell yeah, dude. Extra flip. They're doing that weird thing again.
Wait a second. Yeah, why is that?
I don't know why they do that. I mean, what if I, like...
What are you guys doing to my deck?
No, look at it. Yeah. I think it's just this one that doesn't like it. Yeah, okay.
Okay. What card was that? I need to know. Ah. That's okay.
A worthwhile sacrifice. Yeah, you know, you've been a mercenary yourself for a while, so you would know that, you are accompanying the great Deep Fry, the Destroyer, another mercenary.
Hell yeah.
Of horrible acclaim. He's deep fried many a foe. And he seems to think that you are one of his dreaded nugget knights.
Well, I ain't gonna argue with that.
Is he a good guy or a bad guy?
We'll come back to you in a little bit. So Zedjan, what are you? You know,
I'm pole vaulting the wall with my sword.
Thank God.
I hope
Thank
that is where this
God,
is.
That's what I was hoping for.
Okay. Give me agility swords, dude.
Agility swords.
And agility and health. I'll hero P that.
Damn, dude, and the hero P? Yeah, you fucking... Your sword's just long enough that you fucking take a little run, stab it right in front of the wall, and, you know, launch yourself over it. Fucking straight to the top. And when you get there, you use your momentum, grab the handle, wham, dude, bring the sword up with you.
Hoorah! No good nights, how about you?
And, you know, as you're celebrating your victory, I'll say Sergeant Sizzle, he's climbing up the wall too, and he'll probably... I guess he'll help Dingle up before he does anything else. So yeah, so Sergeant Sizzle climbed up the wall too, and you'll hear from your left, which is where the western gate is. You'll hear,
"Huh! Look, Squire! They've come to battle us! Well, you will never take our gate. Not from Sir Strawberry and Squire Shortcake. You will be beaten and battered. Draw your weapons."
As you're now in combat with, Sir Strawberry and Squire Shortcake, dude. They're coming for you, dude.
They're coming.
Sergeant?
Look, so you setting up the watch together.
And what's you guys' initiatives, too?
They're in order of initiative. The cards.
No, but, like, what's the numbers?
It's, I think, five. Me and Zell are both five.
Okay, both of you give me a card, then. Or one.
Oh, that's not what I wanted.
Alright, you can put the crit back in there.
Mr. Warrior, battle music.
I guess you could just use it on the next flip. Actually, you didn't even need to flip because you're not in this combat, but...
Okay.
Good thing you did anyways.
I'll just leave it there, I guess.
Yeah, you just leave it there.
You might need it on your next roll.
Okay, Neil, you'll go first.
Okay, so it's cool that these guys both announced their names, because that means I get +2 flips against both of them.
Oh, nice. I don't know what all of this you guys have, but that's just sort of their thing though.
So are these guys around the same size? Is there like a bigger one or a smaller one? I'm assuming that the Squire is the smaller one.
Squire is the smaller one, yeah. Not quite as armored. Looks a little wiry.
Alright. I'm gonna approach, I think it was Sir Strawberry, right?
Sir Strawberry.
I'm gonna approach him, I'm just gonna go, "Ah, sir, you see, I just can't help but, you know, it's an excellent speech you gave and everything, sir, but I just can't help but notice that while you were talking about your gate, it appeared someone just so happened to sort of slip it open and walk inside." And my intention is I want to make him turn around so I can slip a grenade in his pocket, so I can slip an explosive in his pocket, Fallout style.
Charm persuasion, dude. Actually, charm sneaking, dude.
I have none of those. That is
maybe actually because it is so bad, dude. I'll give you wit sneaking for it, dude.
All right, so that's two cards, and then I know their name. So sleuthing gives me another two,
and you're healthy.
And I'm healthy,
and you have 2 hero points.
Well, I'll use one of them.
Yeah, he goes,
"I'll do it. I'll take that.
The glory of our defense is breached. No, it cannot be.
He turns around. And you just put a little. You put well. I mean, you put a little bot like a fucking stick of dynamite that lit in his pocket.
Just a little. Lit.
And he turns around and he goes, "You knave! You dare lie!"
Oh, my
Sir Strawberry, an honorable knight, you would be this dishonorable to me.
Oh, my mistake, sir. You see, I thought it was someone entering the gate, but I must have been mistaken. You see, my eyes really aren't what they used to be these days.
And then his pants explode. Ah!
You might want to get that checked out. You know, my wife's got this amazing tailor. She knew him. She's known him since high school. I could get you his number if you want.
I'll say he's in full plate armor, but now he's except for his legs are completely uncovered and he's got like a heart.
I was gonna say he's got heart print boxers.
Yeah, he's got white boxers with red hearts on them. He's like,
oh. My shame discovered! You will pay for this! You dastardly villain!
And, you know,
prepare for a whisking!
And he, you know, you'll have at you, you know.
Damn, he's gonna whisk me? What the fuck?
Yeah, he begins whisking. Oh shit, dude. And he'll do, yeah, he's 4 damage coming for you, dude.
He whisked pretty good.
That literally
that killed him.
I'm literally
oh, shit,
just
dude.
Dead.
Oh shit, dude.
Can I? Ooh. I mean, I'm a ways away, but can I sense his danger and try to heal him from where I'm at?
When you die in combat, don't you get a chance to come back to life?
I feel good about my death saving throws. I feel fine.
Yeah, he's not dead yet. He's just down.
I got 3 death saving throws.
I'll say he knocked you off the side of the wall.
Wait, I was fighting this guy on top of the wall?
Yeah.
Oh shit.
Yeah, you're on
Are we all on top of the wall?
No, I'm on the ground.
Not anymore. Yeah, Bear Grylls is on ground level too.
Did I get over the wall or am I on it?
You're on the wall.
Okay.
You got just on top of it. You want to pole vault a wall, like, over it, dude? That's a bad idea.
Yeah, you don't know what's on the other side.
I mean, you get up that first 30 feet, but how are you going to get down the next?
Well, I think people were just thinking, I was definitely under the assumption that our flip was that we were all flipping to clear the wall.
Yeah.
Oh,
I also thought that, yeah.
I mean, this is fine, I just...
Sorry, I was imagining you were all getting on top of the wall.
Alright.
That's where you are.
Yeah, that's why I went through the gate.
Yeah, I think I'm just gonna... You'll see in a minute. Okay,
Did he fall off, like, the opposite side of the wall, or is he inside the...
What do you mean? He's in the... He fell, like... into the
Well, there's
castle.
Two sides of the wall, so I was asking if he fell into the castle or is he back on the other side?
He fell into the castle.
Alright.
Okay, next. What's your initiative?
4, I believe.
Okay, give me a card.
Oh, yeah.
Okay. Yeah, you can freaking keep it for the next flip.
Oh, hell yeah.
Well, you guys are just fucked anyways. I just killed Dingle, dude. That was awesome.
I just got whisked to death.
You got whisked, dude.
So wait, who's the guy who whisked him? It wasn't the guy who got blown up, right? What's the other one called?
It was the guy who got blown up.
Oh, okay.
Yeah.
It wasn't blown up, it's just his pants were blown up.
I blew up his pants. Yeah.
Watch this, Sir Strawberry. I will. I'll take these other combatants.
And Squire Shortcake, he pulls out a little hand crossbow and he fucking fires a bolt right at you, Mr. Henry Steele.
Oh, was that not my turn?
Oh, right, it is your turn. Sorry. My bad. I'm stoned, dude.
I get my sword out. I try and, like, get it underneath his feet to, like, get him on the sword, and I'm gonna fling him like a catapult.
Which one?
Strawberry. Because he just...
Okay. Yeah, he just flung your dude. Yeah,
that's my flip. Fair.
I'll say that's, bronze swords, dude. How could that not be bronze swords, dude?
I'm putting some drive on that.
Double stank on there.
Four successes to launch Sir Strawberry.
Okay, yeah, I'll say, yeah, you know, you... I won't say that you can't really get the sword under his feet, so, no, you know, you're about to give up. But, you just slap him in the thigh, and he goes, "Ouch!" And that seems to do it, as he falls over the side of the wall and crashes into your tunnel, Bear Grylls. This half-armored knight.
I like to think he just falls into the hole and, like, only his fucking, like, legs and underwear are sticking out, just kicking.
Yeah.
I wanna assess the survivability of this man.
He's... His legs are completely broken, but the rest of him looks fairly formidable.
I want to try to convince him to join our cause, and in return, I'll save his life.
Well, first Squire Shortcake's turn, and then we'll.
Well, he just fell into my house. I thought I had, you know.
It's okay.
Precedence.
Maybe.
Can I use a reaction to convince him to join our side?
Just give me a second, okay?
Okay.
It's first.
He's bound, so he's likely just going to be trying to get out.
Squire Shortcake, with wide eyes, looks towards Henry Steele and says, "You bastard! My, he's a knight! You are but a filthy peasant!" And he's going to rush at you with a dagger. The Squire Shortcake.
Yeah, he does 13 damage.
Nah, he doesn't do 13 damage, dude. He fucking double Joker, dude. So you're pretty happy. Like, you just knocked this dude off the wall. You're like, damn, that. Maybe I didn't, like, throw him off, but. Damn, that was pretty good. Like, you're patting yourself on the back a little bit. And then, you know, you hear Squire Shortcake, you know, scream out a yell of, revenge. And, you're like, but now I could try it. And, he steps right onto your blade, and he goes right over the wall. And, plunges straight onto, Sir Strawberry's whisker. As we'll call it. And now, two people have entered your tunnel, your abode. Oh. And one of them is impaled on the other's weapon. And I'll say right outside of the tunnel is also Columbomb, who's not breathing right.
Some might say he's not breathing at all.
Columbomb fell off the wall as well, okay.
Is it the strawberry guy or the other guy that's not impaled?
It's Squire Shortcake is impaled on Sir Strawberry's weapon.
Yeah,
and so Sir Strawberry has a couple of very broken legs.
I tell Sir Strawberry that I can fix his legs if he fights for us. I'm recruiting
Give me
him.
Charm persuasion, I guess.
Oh, shit.
Damn!
What a threat.
Interesting.
To think I would ever betray my honor in such a way. You do not know who you...
And you can hear it cracking and grinding as he begins to stand on his broken legs.
You do not know who you are speaking to. I would rather die with my honor.
And he's going to charge at you with, as a Squire Church Cage screaming, because he's still on the whisker, which I'm just imagining is like a fucking, like a lance or some shit.
He's gonna charge at him with both of his legs broken?
Yeah, because his honor's so strong. His honor's so powerful. And he's, he's gonna do, 3 damage to you and then be undodgeable and then fall to the ground. Actually, it's dodgeable, so you don't die too. But then you'll fall to the ground dead. And Scryshirt Cake's just going. And we'll cut back to Snurt and Early. Snurt, you were being dragged through the hallways of the castle, as you know, there's fighting around every corner.
Come!
You know, you have to either side of you is a Nugget Knight. You almost feel a little camaraderie as they're just as ugly as you are. And,
hell yeah.
Yeah, it's like a labyrinth, these hallways. You know, you're going left and right and back and forth. And, all the time following, Deep Fry the Destroyer. And, eventually you reach a door that's plated in gold and embellished with jewels and stuff. It looks, very pompous. Anyways, dude, you freaking Deep Fry throws the door open and says,
"Come, we must go now."
And you see like a sort of you see like an old man in a robe with what are those things called? He's got a cinnamon bun on his head. And he's sitting next to, a heavy set young lady with a basket that's got a cloth covering it. But she seems to be dressed in very rich clothing, fine silk. And the old skinny man, he grabs, this girl's hand and he says,
"Come, princess, it is time to leave this castle. We may lose this battle, but we must not lose the war."
And he grabs her hand and starts rushing out the door. You and your party make your way, you run down a few more hallways and, Deep Fry, the old man, he says,
"Stop!"
And he pulls on a fucking, a sconce. And, it opens a passageway. And, you begin to run through this passageway with your... with your party.
Okay.
Well, I mean, they begin to go through the passageway. You don't have to go with if you don't want to. Actually.
No, I'm seeing where this is going. Yes.
Oh, yeah. And then, back to the other party. Sorry, I couldn't think of anything that would actually have a choice for you to do.
That's fair.
But... I'll let you go. I'll let you have 2 actions on your next turn, dude. You know what? There you go. Back to you guys.
Nerly's time is coming.
Bear Grylls, you're fucked up. Fucking Henry Steele, you're feeling on top of the world. You know, the Sergeant Sizzle walks up to you. You know, he was taking care of a couple other ruffians on the wall. He says,
"You did good work there. Yeah, they did good work there."
I don't remember his voice.
"But you did good work there."
"Thank you, Sergeant, now, but we've got a few casualties."
I will go perform my duty. I'm going to get that boy, Columbom. I'm going to get him fixed up. And we're gonna hold this wall, though. I'm counting on you."
You know, he rushes.
"Yes, sir."
You know, he flips the ladder over the wall, and he begins to climb down. And you know, from the opposite way of the gate, you know, you hear armored footsteps. And you know, a couple voices say,
"Oh well, looky here. We'll get rewarded finally for killing the men who took down Sir Strawberry."
And, you know, a couple of biscuit bandits draw their blades and start to come upon you. Henry Steele.
Arr!
And it's combat.
Bring your
worst.
Are
you going to get my death saving throw?
No, you're up at 1 HP. The sergeant gets to you. He says,
"You're going to be all right. You're gonna be alright, son."
"Oh. Sorry, sir. I appear to have dozed off for a second there."
"Yeah, you have a abdominal injury. You're dying. You
no,
almost
no,
out.
That's no, no, that's fine, sir. That'll come right out."
Okay, well, it's your turn. Well, actually, no turn for you. Henry Steele, it's your turn.
Alright, I gotta swing my sword. I'm swinging at both of them, though. Get him in one hit.
Okay, swinging at both of them.
Bronze swords.
Yeah, bronze swords, sorry, yeah. I forgot I was the DM for a second.
Perfect. 2 and a joker.
You do a mighty swing.
It's too mighty. And,
it is. Well, yes, it is too mighty. You know, because as you barely even touch him. You graze one of them slightly, a small cut appearing on his cheek, and then the heft of your sword carries you careening over the wall. Towards your compatriots.
Yes, I'm joining the crew.
You hit the ground with a thud. Doc, it is your turn.
I'd like to drink my own piss to recover my health.
Give me intelligence survival.
Oh.
But you're unhealthy, dude.
Yeah. What's the penalty?
Half cards. Half cards rounded up.
You recover. You fucking. You crawl through your tunnel. You know, back to the water skin you left. And you. It's almost not enough. You refill it once. And drink it again, and you recover 2 HP by drinking your own piss. Which is now a staple of RPG, apparently.
I think it's just a staple of Bear Grylls.
Okay, and you know, the two biscuit bandits, they go, "Well, guess that's our job done." And they rush over to the western gate, and they begin, you know, turning the, they begin opening it as you, snert and early, break out into the wide open courtyard. On the other side of the, you with your party of you know, Deep Fry the Destroyer and his Nugget Knights, along with the, now, which you now know is the Princess Pound Cake, and her court mixologist. You see on the other side of the courtyard the Western Gate. They're attempting to escape.
What?
It's opening.
No.
The gate. It's opening. Your team. They failed. And you, the squad. You see. You know the princess and her knightly guard. They're making their escape. This is what you're supposed to be protecting against. And now, here, 1 second. With Deep Fry the Destroyer, he will, you know, this mighty, mighty knight. He runs, he grabs the princess by the arm. He starts running towards the gate, and I guess he won't do anything. He's just gonna run towards the gate with the princess. It's your turn, Snurt Nerdly.
Alright. So that guy with the cinnamon bun head, that was the mixologist? I thought that was the king.
Yes. That was the mixologist.
Okay, that changes my plans then.
The highest royalty here is would be the king of the fakers is not.
Man, him running away with it kind of messes with things a bit.
I'll do it all. So you're here, and you got your buddies, and this is Deep Fry, with the princess, and trailing behind them is the court mixologist. So you guys are like running behind. I mean, you're all together still, kind of basically.
Yeah.
And I don't really have anything to put here, but
you know what?
You know, the gate is like.
See,
Where's the gate?
You guys are like right here. Sergeant Henry has just fallen down. Did you fall? I made you fall off the wall, right? Zedge?
No, I think Zedge's still on top.
No, I fell off. I got a jump.
No, you fell down. Yeah.
Right. Yeah, take 2 damage too. Sorry. I meant to say that.
Damn, thought I got away with it.
I'm like, yeah, that's cool, right? And so what are you doing? Your turn first. You can take 2 actions this turn, by the way.
I wanted to see if I could.
Because you get a surprise round.
Yeah, I wanted to see.
You can take an action before he runs away because surprise round.
Okay.
That's how we're
going. I wanted to stealthily kill the princess and take her place.
Holy shit! Oh my god! Dude, give me fucking... Oh my god, dude. What could this even be, dude? It's like a
charm sneaking. Oh no, wait, you're killing them as well.
Yeah. Okay, it's gonna be two flips, okay? Bronze sneaking and then fucking, it's not a disguised one, is it? And then charm sneaking, I guess, for disguise. Bronze sneaking to assassinate and then charm sneaking to disguise itself. at some point in the tunnel, you know, she was at the back and so were you, and that's when you took her place, I guess. Right before he got out. Let's see. Which one's which?
This is the kill.
The kill flip, okay, let's see it.
Yeah, which I already know has the crit.
Alright. Okay, you fucking
the bitch is
yeah,
dead.
You fucking slit her throat, nobody fucking notices you. You start pulling her clothes off faster than any horny teenager ever has, dude.
Maybe he's some kind of doppelganger.
And
I'll hero pee that.
Wrong deck.
I keep doing this.
You got free drive.
Man. I'm so used to that.
Oh,
being...
you did use docs though, yeah.
Sorry.
You used docs'
nice.
Hero point as well.
Lucky.
He used his hero point and his cards.
Yeah. One. Two.
I'm you driving. Got three. I'll let it for three, dude. You fucking kill her and put her clothes on. You pick up her basket really quick, and the court mixologist looks back, and the court mixologist looks back and he's like, huh? And the light of daylight shines upon you as Deep Fry the Destroyer grabs your arm and begins to rush towards the Western Gate. Dude. Columbom, you see a mighty warrior dressed in shining golden brown armor running towards you along with your squad mate cross-dressing? What do you do? Yeah, the blood loss might be getting to you, honestly. Also, you guys can refresh your dodge. Because it's a new combat. If you used it last combat, I can't remember.
Nice.
I used it unwillingly to save myself.
Yeah, you guys had a moment to catch your breath, kind of.
Yeah, and plus I drank my piss.
Okay, so we gotta remove this, the princess, and put Martin here. All
right.
What about
Okay. So let me clarify the scene right now. So I can tell that the person in the princess outfit is Nasty Nerd. Do I know the person who is, like, who... Do I know the person, the other person? Do I recognize this guy?
What was it? What did I... What flip did I make you do to know him? It was something space-wise?
It was... Was it intelligence?
I think it's intelligence space-wise, huh?
Yeah, it was three... Yeah.
Intelligence space-wise, to see if his reputation precedes him.
Alright, is that gonna be my flip?
No.
Okay, good. Oh, whoops. Wait, no. Actually, this is...
You're at one health.
Okay, so that's three cards. This is actually perfect.
I don't think you know.
You hit your head, and now you've got snert vision.
Everyone looks like Snurt.
There's not like any characters that this dude has. Like, is there any way I can turn this around to like make a reference to Columbo?
I haven't seen it.
Does he like hate his dad or something?
No.
There.
Did he have a bully?
Is there like a super villain that he can never catch or something?
I don't think so, actually. Columbo episodes are pretty self-contained.
What's something
you've always struggled with your faith, and now before you, the Lord himself, Jesus Christ, come to absolve you of your sins. I don't know, dude. I'm trying to think. Maybe Jesus Christ isn't the way.
I mean, I was hoping this Joker would just make him, would just make me think that this guy is an enemy so that I could do the flip I was planning, which is definitely not the right call, but it is the move I want to make.
Understandable.
You well, want, wait, I'm confused, dude.
He is an enemy.
He wants to attack that guy.
This guy isn't, okay, I thought this guy, I thought any baked goods were the enemies, so the Nugget Knight was a good guy.
No.
I assumed it was like a savory versus sweet kind of situation.
He's a mercenary.
Ah, okay.
Yeah. He's been hired by the bakers.
Oh,
field.
Well, you know what? I know exactly what I'm gonna do.
But you...
I'm gonna blow a hole in the wall to let him fit through.
Yeah, you do think he's your friend. Okay, yeah, sure.
I'm gonna blow a hole in the wall like I wanted to do at the start of the session.
I mean, it's so stupid, it makes no sense. Please do it.
Oh.
Give me, you know,
if he plants his bombs carefully, he can probably make the rubble of the hole fall into my hole.
Let's see if he rolls a Joker.
Let's see. Let's put a drive on that. Yeah, one more. And a third drive.
No, about a fourth.
What about a fourth?
But surely the fifth.
All my drive?
Oh, yeah, okay. That's cool. Yeah, you, You want to describe it?
Yeah, so I'm gonna walk over to the wall, kind of around where Doc's hole is, and just sort of like blow just like a giant hole into the side of the wall, and just go like, "Oh, right this way, sir." Yeah, I can see you and Nerd are in a big rush. Just come here, you go. You're not gonna have to bother with all that climbing and blowing yourself up business. Just right through here.
Okay. Yeah, you sure, yeah, you blow on the wall and you know it's a bit further away from the rest of the party than the open gate is, so I guess he starts to move in that direction. So. And it'll go to Mr. Henry Steele's turn.
Okay, give me a quick rundown of the situation
now
he's around.
I'll say there's a hole in the wall. You guys are in the hole right here. And a hole in the wall over here. Now he's started to veer towards that.
So Columbo's over here.
Nugget Knights are coming towards you guys. The court mixologist is still following them.
Wouldn't all these guys be by the hole since the
hole's
by
the hole in the wall, dude. No, but I'm saying the hole, sure it's still near your hole, okay? But it's
no,
further
he,
it's further away from
it,
the gate.
He placed it right above my hole, I'm pretty sure.
He said it was near your hole.
Yeah, so it'd be near me.
Listen, Doc. You want to play this game, dude? Because it's about to be wall falls and everyone in the hole dies, okay? So, you better watch yourself, motherfucker.
So the Nugget Knights are approaching the hole in the wall?
The Nugget Knights are coming towards you guys, and Fry... I almost called him Frylock. Deep Fry the Destroyer is going towards the hole in the wall with Snert and Early. With the mixologist falling close behind. Actually, let me check this. Oh shit! And you know what? I fucked up because I... You know what? I'm just gonna say fuck it and make his initiative 3-2.
Alright, I'm just gonna take a big swing at the Nugget Knights, I guess.
Oh, and the two... Mind you, the two Biscuit Bandits are also...
Oh, can I forget?
On the wall above. But yeah, you can take a swing at the Nugget Knights. Give me a bronze swords.
Bet.
AM.
Yeah, there you.
There's the other one.
You do a wide swing towards these Nugget Knights and, but, you know, they both deftly dodge out of the way, and your sword gets caught in the ground, and, the momentum of it, it brings you back to the top of the wall. Where the Biscuit Bandits, they start kicking you for 2 damage. Undodgeable. You're on the ground, they're kicking the shit out of you. You're back on top of the wall!
They pulled him back onto the wall? Out of him?
No. He swings
the sword, backward vaulted.
Yeah.
Oh, okay.
Accidentally vaulted.
Okay, I missed that part. It just sounded like they fucking grabbed him and pulled him back up on the wall to beat the shit out of him up there.
Yeah, he vaulted back up through an accident. They start kicking the shit out of him. Like, what the fuck are you doing up here, asshole? You know, but the gate is already half open, though.
Man, we're doing really well.
This is good.
And it will go to... I should do this for myself. It won't. Okay, first the court mixologist. I feel bad you have the thing that makes it so if you know people's names that you get more flips, because I have a dumbass name for this guy. I'm not even gonna say it now.
Well, I mean, you can say it as long as it's not me. If my character knows it, I get +2.
Alright,
I got +2 for the other guys because they announced their names as soon as combat started.
Yeah,
fair enough. Court mixologist Pillsbury Dawboy. You know, he's gonna try to use his magic to you know, what's that stuff called? It's like peanut. Oh yeah, he's gonna pepper you guys, yes, with a storm of peanut brittle. Thanks for saying it.
You're welcome.
Alright, everybody's gonna take take 1 damage as peanut brittle rains from the sky.
You guys all have 1 from that.
I'm also gonna assume it's dodgeable.
You know what? Yeah, you are safe from that. And it is dodgeable.
Yeah, he wouldn't be launching his peanut brittle storm at the princess.
Yeah. That's
true. Well, man, I fucked up making only 1 damage. But I can't go back now.
Brown's like, damn, I can't believe I didn't get to kill Dingle again.
Well, I was thinking about it. Yeah. Yeah, fair enough. Okay, now the Nugget Knights are gonna approach you guys and
Nugget Knights.
You know, the first one, he's gonna walk up and he's gonna walk up to Sergeant Sizzle. He's gonna stab him in the gut. He's gonna be like, "You're not our captain anymore, buddy." You know, there's some history there, it seems like. And Sergeant Sizzle's fucking dead.
Damn.
And to the next
one. Sizzle the pink one?
No, use the blue one. Oh, and okay. Now, the other Nugget Knight, he's gonna walk over to Bear Grylls and he'll stab at you for one damage. Attempts to, he's gonna fucking poke you with his sword, dude.
Oh, okay. Sorry.
He doesn't accept your apology.
It's fucked up.
And how much? Your initiative is 2? Draw a card with me. Actually, I guess it would be Sejin's turn first. But yeah, did Sejin already go? Yeah, he did.
Yeah,
I don't want that 3 for my next draw.
So, it'll be the Biscuit Bandits first. Okay, get all these cards out of here real quick. And they're just gonna kick the shit out of you, Zedge, to be honest.
Cool.
Since you're kinda on the ground.
Fight back! Fight back!
And you got a 3 damage incoming. As they're just fucking like, say uncle! Say uncle!
Three damage?
3 damage, yeah. And they grab your hand and they're like, trying to make you hit yourself with it. Why are you hitting yourself? It doesn't really hurt, but it's really embarrassing. As it comes to Bear Grylls' turn.
I'm going to, when someone's encountered with something, they can either, it's fight or flight, And I'm not a fighter, I'm a flighter. I'm gonna run to the safest location possible.
Give me agility survival. To flee. Might as well just use all your drive and your hero point, too.
Yeah. That's my drive. Oh, there's the crit.
You retreat through your tunnel, run towards the woods, keep running. This is your home. This is where you belong, not on some battlefield.
So I'm like way over here.
Yeah, you're like, yeah, actually, no, you're like down. You're like up here. You drink your own piss again. You feel better. You feel stronger.
In the forgotten treasure forest.
Bear Grylls has left the session.
Also, since I... oh no. Bear Grylls, I'm gone.
Bear Grylls has successfully retreated from combat. Entirely.
Bear Grylls has successfully survived.
Bear Grylls has survived and deserted the army.
I'm an army deserter now. I've gone AWOL.
I was about to say, Bear Grylls has gone AWOL.
Damn.
And you cover yourself in mud. No one's gonna find you.
And I as I'm running, I have a branch behind me to cover my tracks.
Yeah, no, you cover all your tracks, dude. You don't leave even a single, inkling of piss behind.
Damn. I like to see you try to kill me at the end of this session.
You fall into a never mind. It's 2 deliverance. Okay, now it is Deep Fry the Destroyer's turn again. He's gonna start running towards the hole, and he's gonna, on his way, he'll take a swing at you. At you, Columbomb. I'll be honest, he kills you.
Can I activate my Martyrdom perk?
What does that do?
When you die, it drops grenades on you.
Is that a real thing?
It is in Call of Duty Modern Warfare 2.
Give me presence explosives. to give your life to kill this man.
All right, so that's 4 cards. I'm gonna use my last hero point.
Yeah, because I was gonna flip for this dude, but he's got lethal 1 on his flips.
I'm bleeding out and dying, and I go, just 1 more thing. and grenades just fall out of my big coat.
Okay, dead. Dead. Half HP. You take 4 damage. Dodgeable. But you're not dead, but you're gonna have to start flipping death saving throws, Zell. As Columbomb vaporizes himself in an explosion. One of the Nugget Knights is killed. You know, I'll even say fucking one of the Biscuit Bandits falls to his death as well. As, you know, a bit more of the wall crumbles. You know, you and Deep Fry the Destroyer are blown to the ground. I'll say this guy probably takes some damage too. Okay, so everybody's taking damage. Well, everybody, let me write this shit down real quick.
Did I take any damage?
Roll me a... No, you don't take any damage, dude. Actually, okay. Roll me, give me 1 card, dude. Give me 1 card, luck flip. 1 card, luck flip. a bit of the stone from the wall, a bit of the rubble. flies a few miles to the northwest and lands on your head,
killing you instantly.
Give me, you die instantly.
Oh,
okay. So that's taken care of.
Yeah, you flee to the safest place when you had failed to consider the safest place when everything blew up.
And
he's not omniscient.
Now it is. Yeah. Now it's Mr. Henry Steele's turn.
So I'm still on top of the wall with several of these guys.
You're on top of the wall with 1 Biscuit Bandit.
I'm gonna plunge my sword into the wall and just try and make it crumble.
Okay, give me brawn engineering.
What the fuck? I'm doing the opposite of engineering. I'm dismantling.
Yeah, but you need to know the weak points.
With my sword.
Give me intelligent swords then.
Fuck you.
Either one of those flips.
I'm drawing him, but...
What's the hell?
Okay, yeah. Yeah. You know what? You lift your sword and you smack it into the ground below you. And, the wall beneath you begins to crumble. And, you ride it down like a surfboard, and all the rocks land on top of the Biscuit Bandit. Who's now KIA. In front of you, however, is an angry-looking Nugget Knight, who immediately slashes towards you. And, he'll deal about 1 damage as he cuts you with his blade. He's gonna cut you, dude.
He's going to cut.
For 1 damage.
Alright.
It will go to... Okay, the Pillsbury Doughboy, he It's gonna try to. This would be. He's gonna run over to you, and he's gonna, Mr. Snurtin' Early. He's gonna try to pull the basket from your hands.
Basket.
Yeah, I think you can give me a. Just roll me a pure brawn flip.
Okay. Am I still, unconscious?
Unconscious? Wait. Oh, right, you have no health. I forgot about that. Yeah, okay, he's gonna run over to you and he's gonna grab the fucking basket. And you're knocked out, right?
Yeah.
And, Deep Frog go like,
"But we must save the princess too."
He goes,
"No, the recipe is what's important."
And he said, and Deep Frog goes, "That's not what I was paid for." And he'll try to cast a spell on him.
I like how there's definitely still something that's going on in the background we know nothing about.
As he zaps Deep Fry the Destroyer with a bolt of baking energy. You know, they begin to, you know, square up with each other. And as it goes back to.
Only a couple playable characters.
Snurt Nurly, give me a fucking death saving throw.
Can I drive this?
Yeah, I don't care. Yeah, sure.
Cool.
So you fail. But isn't it three to die?
Three, yeah. Do I fail now?
No, you just failed one.
Okay.
Now it's Henry Steele's turn again. In front of you is one Nugget Knight. And you see the court mixologists and Deep Fry the Destroyer squaring up with each other over.
I brandish my sword heroically and hold it straight into the air and attempt to just scare this Nugget Knight off.
Okay, give me charm swords.
Charm swords.
Yeah, he looks at you. Sword. He looks at your sword. He looks at, the devastation among him, and he drops his weapon and he runs out of the crack in the wall. As it goes back, I guess these guys will fight each other. Real quick. It's a Deep Fry slashes the mixologist. Lets out a scream of pain. And, shoots back with a, magical spell. That fizzles in his hand. Oh, it's his, you can see his flesh and bones vaporize from his skin as he turns himself into a pile of dust. And Deep Fry the Destroyer quickly picks up Snurtin' Early, puts him on his back, and begins to rush out of the crack on the wall as well. It goes back to your turn, Henry Steele.
So wait. No. Nurt is currently disguised as the princess.
Mm-hmm.
But he's also dying.
But is the princess on our side or is that their princess?
The princess is dead. But it's their princess.
It's their princess.
Yeah.
I mean, I'm just gonna ignore them and claim the castle since they're running away.
Claim the castle? What do you mean?
The fort that we're in.
What do you mean claim it?
It's their enemy territory, occupied. Right? I'm occupying it.
Well, yeah, I mean, the whole... it's already occupied. Oh. You know, you can see the banner of your army is being raised on the highest bastions of this castle. Right. As you know, your army is taking decisive victory.
I take off in hot pursuit of the dead princess's body, which I'm gonna use as a trophy.
give me wit investigation. I get find the dead princess's corpse.
Well, he's going after the real dead princess's corpse.
I know. You can roll me another death saving throw, though.
Okay.
Is that all your flips?
No. Nice.
Oh, you're good. That one's a success, dude.
That's a success.
Does that mean you're up? How does this work?
I think so.
That means you're up with one, like, HP. One HP.
You're up with one HP. You're currently on the back of Deep Fried the Destroyer, who is rushing away from the castle and into the woods.
How does my chase go?
Oh, your search for the dead princess's body? Well, you sort of just walk through the area you saw Snert and Early come out of earlier, and a ways down this tunnel you find the dead princess. Completely naked.
This is when I come back to and my internet comes back.
I position her on the end of my sword and hold her up high. Look around, all you would-be nugget knights. This is what happens when you go against us.
Yeah, a few chef's guard soldiers, rush down the passageway and see you holding this naked woman on your sword, and they're let's see how they feel about it.
You're pulling from the discard pile.
No, I think he's clearing his own.
Oh.
Yeah, they're like, yeah, blood. Ah! They're real riled up about it. They're like, damn, this guy's brutal. They think your sword's awesome too, dude. So, are you gonna do anything, Mr. Snert and Early?
There's nothing I can really do to, like, heal myself.
Not really.
A bashed kit.
I mean, you could try.
Actually, I don't have that basket. He took it with him.
Oh, did he? The dead guy took it?
Well, I'll say Deep Fry's carrying the basket now.
Deep Fry's carrying. Maybe I'll try to, like, see if I can grab the recipe out of the basket. That's what was being carried in.
Yeah. Give me, wit sneaking? Or maybe agility sneaking, actually?
Sure. So that'd be 5 total.
It rounds up, so yeah, 3.
1 to 3.
Yeah, you just slip it out and into your pocket.
Sick.
I mean, and do you want to stay on his back? I'll see if you can get off for free if you want to.
Sure. Yeah. I'll say to him, like,
I'll hold back, find some help, deliver the goods.
No, princess, we must keep going. They could be sending who knows how many men after us.
Well, uh,
I don't know.
Maybe a look over there.
Look over there.
He looks over there.
I hide.
You hide?
I mean, I will say, like, you're not that far from the castle, and the entire outside of it is your people, you know?
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? But, yeah, if you wanna sneak away from, yeah, give me, what is sneaking, dude? Fuck. Wit sneaking. Maybe presence sneaking.
Sure. That's right, yeah. Yeah. I'm using my ultimate skulk.
What does that do?
I may resolve the action as if I had flipped 3 successes.
Okay. Yeah, you fucking skulk away. He, you know, he's left standing in the middle in a clearing going, "Princess! Princess!" And you sneak back to your lines as Henry Steele is marching around with a dead woman's corpse on the end of his sword, and if your buddy's corpses are being pulled, you know, back into camp. Not Bear Grylls's though. No one will ever find him.
Or mine, because there's no body left.
There's no trace.
Here's a bunch of chunks, yeah. And, yeah, so you and Henry, you know, after the battle is over, the, culinary commander and chef, Captain Crouton, you see him approaching again on his horse, you know, his sword bloodied, says,
"Oh, that was a good battle, hey, chaps! Well, have you anything to show for yourselves? The entire Western Wall was blown to pieces. Who knows how many enemies escaped? And we searched the whole castle. We were not even able to find the treasure we were sent here for, the great relic of the past, of which I will not speak. It's a mere peasantry. And perhaps they left with it through the back, through that giant gaping hole in the wall. What do you have to say for yourselves?"
I hold my sword towards him, with the princess still on the end of it, of course. So, "My comrades died in this valiant battle, and we recaptured precious territory. How about you have some respect for your frontline men?"
"Well, how about you have some respect for authority?"
I tried to chop his head off.
Jesus Christ.
Okay, give me bronze swords, dude.
Let's go.
Oh, this is perfect.
Alright, 2 and a joker.
Sorry, I'm trying to think.
You swing the sword, and the princess's corpse high-fives them as it passes.
Give me a second, okay? Give me a second.
Yeah. Yeah, see, I found this funny piece of paper.
Okay, actually, that is a good point. You think, "Oh, I'm gonna cut this asshole's head off. You know what? I'm tired of this guy's shit." And you know, you lift your sword, but you're not really used to swinging it with a body impaled on it. So, you know, the added weight, you know, you sort of go, and the sword, it falls towards Snurt Nerdly, but you just barely dodge out of the way. And it cuts a hole in his dress. And now on the end of your sword, a piece of paper, which Captain Crouton grabs. And he says, you fool! You fool! This was it! The recipe for the perfect sourdough bread! And you've ruined it! Men, seize him! As you're brought to the stocks.
Okay.
And Captain Crouton, he looks at you nerdily and he says,
Perhaps we can find some way to recover the information contained in this paper. I thank you, soldier. Maybe some success will come from this battle today, from the lives laid down. You are promoted. Captain Snert Nerly, from this day until the last of your days. Now be gone with you.
I be gone.
Yeah, you're raised to a position of authority. You have many soldiers at your command. You become distinguished in the chef's war against the bakers. And Zed, you get a lot of rocks thrown at you while you're in the stocks, dude.
Oh hell yeah.
The end. Good job, yeah, boys. Yeah. Sorry I killed so many of you.
We did it.
We did something.
You guys had really low HP, it was hard to
not instantly kill him.
Yes. I mean to be fair, I entirely expected my character to die. I rolled a character with one brawn and max explosives and I said, oh yeah, this guy's not surviving to the end of the session.
Yeah. You guys wanna give out hero points? Well, too bad. That's how we do it here.
Damn.
I mean, if you guys want to, I guess we could do that.
I give both of my hero points to myself for dying and being cool.
Epic.
Oh. Based.
I give both of mine to Dingle for the same reason.
Okay. Nice. Dingle next session gets 5 hero points instead of 2. The rest of you still get 1.
You know what? I like. I do gotta say, I really did like Henry's character, and you know, Bear Grylls' escape plan. I thought it was pretty good. But,
it was pretty solid until the end there.
Some poor luck.
There should be a luck skill so bad.
That's your real life skill that determines how well you flip.
Yeah, I guess, fair enough.
Alright, GG.
Yeah, good game again. Wasn't even that long, it was like an hour and a half. I got short sessions, boys.
Nah, that was pretty good length, I think.
Yeah, I didn't even use all
my started
time.
Late, so it was fine. That was a shorter session.
Yeah.
Yeah, but I just, you know. You guys weren't making as many food puns because it's my fault. I fell off. I fucked up at the beginning.
You fell off.
You fell off.
I fell off.
Bro, I fell off, dude. Straight up, I fell off. I'm gonna see what Grim's playing, dude. I'm tired of this Binding of Isaac crap.
Damn, yeah.
Tired of it.
All right.